Hello friends, how are you? In this video, we'll discuss about speed control of a vehicle, or it is a cruise control using fuzzy logic. Now, let two fuzzy inputs, say speed difference and accelerations, say two inputs are there and one fuzzy output throttle control be there. So we can see this particular diagram where this is what our vehicle speed control. Here two inputs are there, speed difference and acceleration. Suppose speed difference and acceleration. And there is one output that is throttle control or TC. So we want to implement this fuzzy speed control or vehicle speed control using fuzzy logic. Now you can see here, let the fuzzy rule base contains following rules to control the vehicles. Now these are the rules. You can see these are the rules. Now we can see, first of all, you just see the fuzzy partition. So this is what fuzzy partition. So NL, NM, NS, GE, PS, PM and this is what positive large PL are there. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 fuzzy partitions are there. So NL means negative large. Okay, NM means negative medium. NS means negative small. GE means 0. PS means positive small. PM is positive medium. And PL stands for positive large. So we can see here negative L, it is open left fuzzy set. PL is what? It is open right fuzzy set, but remaining NM, NS, GE, PS, PM all are triangular fuzzy sets. And this is what our universal course of discourse. Okay, so it is from 0 to it is 240. Okay, now you just see the rules. So you can see R1, R2 to 8 rules are there. So this is what our antecedent part, this is what our consequent part. So it is what multiple antecedents are there. So if speed difference is NL and acceleration is GE, then throttle control is PL, positive large. If speed difference is GE and acceleration is negative large, then throttle control is positive large. If speed difference is negative medium and acceleration is 0, then throttle control is positive medium. And in this way, 8 rules are there. Okay, and here NL, GE, NM, all these are what? These are called fuzzy linguistic variable or the fuzzy sets. So these are what? The fuzzy sets. Now you can see the fuzzy inputs. So you can see fuzzy input part or input fuzzy partition. So you can, this is for the speed difference. So 0 to 60, it is negative large. Okay, so till 30 it is 1, after that, after 60 it will be 0. Similarly, NM is what? In between 30 to 90. So NM is maximum when it is 60. NS is 60 to 120. NS is maximum when it is 90. Then 90 to 150 GE. GE is maximum when it is 120 and so on. This is nothing but a fuzzy partition for the acceleration. So it is also from 0 to 240 inverse of discourse. So here also 7 fuzzy partitions are there. So 0 to 60 it is negative large. 30 to 90 it is negative medium and so on. Now this is what our output fuzzy partition throttle control. Okay, so here it is also 0 to 240. Here also 7 fuzzy partitions are there, NL to PL. Okay, now here for each and every left open fuzzy set, okay, we can use this particular formula to get the membership value. Suppose a value which is in between 0 to alpha, a value x, CRISP value, suppose any CRISP value x1 is in between 0 to alpha, then or less than alpha, definitely the fuzzy value should be what? 1. And if it is more than beta, means somewhere here, always it should be 0. But if it is in between alpha to beta, if the any value of x is in between alpha to beta, then associated fuzzy value will be what? Beta minus x by beta minus alpha. So alpha when the fuzzy value is maximum, okay, last maximum, and beta when fuzzy value is 0. Similarly, if it is open right, like this one, it is what? Open right. So we can see if alpha is what? It is 0. Beta means when it is first maximum. Okay, so the total finally it is what? Till 240. We can see here. If any value is less than alpha, means somewhere here or here, definitely it should be what? It should be 0. You can see it should be 0. Okay, so if any value is less than alpha, definitely it should be 0. Any value which is greater than beta, always it should be 1. Say any value which is more than beta or till 240, means somewhere here or here, in that case definitely it should be 1. At any value in between alpha to beta, definitely the membership value will be what? Beta minus x divided by beta minus alpha. Similarly, if it is a triangular, okay, if it is a triangular, we can apply this particular formula to get the membership value of any x. If x is somewhere here, then we can apply this particular formula. So x minus a max mean x minus a by b minus a comma c minus x by c minus b, and here we have to take the minimum, and from that value we have to compare with 0 and we have to take the maximum. So the parameters are a, b, c. So triangular membership function is maximum when it is b. Okay, so from this particular formula we can get the associated membership value of any Krebs value. So these are the formula through which we can, first we have to convert any Krebs value to fuzzy value, then we can apply the fuzzy inference. Now let the speed difference is 80 and acceleration is 105. So both are Krebs value. First apply fuzzification to get the fuzzy values of the inputs. So let these two are the Krebs input. So first of all, we have to apply fuzzification technique to get the associated fuzzy value. Now we can see here, first one is what? Speed difference, it is 80. Now we can, this is nothing but our fuzzy partition for the speed difference. Okay, now 80 will be what? 80 will be somewhere here. That means the intersections are what? These are the intersections, and it will intersect with NM and NS, fuzzy set NM and NS. So that's why we have to consider only NM and NS, and we have to leave as it is the others. Okay, so here we have to consider NM and NS. So NM is, this is what our NM. So NM is what? It is 30, 60, 90. It is 30, 60, 90. So here we have to apply the associated fuzzy value inside this fuzzy set NM. Okay, now if x is 80, 80 is what? Somewhere here. So we have to apply this particular formula. So mu NM x, okay, so here x is what? It is 80. Max mean, it is what? We can see this particular formula we have to apply. The formula is very simple. Here we have to apply this particular formula. So x minus a by b minus a. So here what is a? A is equal to 30, b is equal to 60, and c is equal to 90. So x minus a means what? 80 minus 30, b minus a, that is 60 minus 30. So 60 minus 30, comma c minus x. What is c? C is 90, 90 minus 80 divided by c minus b. So 90 minus 60. So this is what? 5 by 3, and this is what? 1 by 3. The minimum is what? 1 by 3. And if you compare these two, the maximum is what? 1 by 3. 1 by 3 is what? It is 0.33. Okay. Now the membership value of the NS. Now for already you have calculated the membership value of inside this NM. So if the fuzzy set is NM, associated fuzzy value of Krebs 80 is what? It is 0.33. Similarly, if the fuzzy value of NS, so NS, the NS ABC is what? 60, 90, 120. 60, 90, 180, 60 is what? A, 90, B, 120 is what? C. We have to apply the same formula. So mu NSX means what? The Krebs value, the membership value of X inside this fuzzy set, fuzzy set NS. So max mean 80 minus 60 by 90 minus 60 comma 120 minus 80 divided by 120 minus 90 comma 0. So you can see here, we have to apply this particular formula, X minus A by B minus A comma C minus X divided by C minus B. So this is nothing but our 2 by 3, this is 4 by 3. So minimum is what? 2 by 3. And if you compare these two, the maximum is what? 2 by 3. So 2 by 3 is nothing but 0.67. Okay. Next, so we have identified the associated fuzzy value. Now you can see acceleration A is equal to 105. So if acceleration A is equal to 105, now we can see the fuzzy partition for the acceleration. So 105 is what? That means what? The intersection is what? NS and GE. So you have to consider only these two fuzzy sets, NS and GE. So NS is what? It is 60, 90, 120. NS is what? It is 60, 90 and 120. So 60, 90, 120, then we have to apply this same formula. So if the mu NSA means what? The acceleration value, fuzzy value inside this fuzzy set NS, we have to apply max mean. So here you can apply x minus a. So this is what our a, this is b, this is what our c. X is what? X is 105. So 105 minus 60 by 90 minus 60. X minus a my by b minus a comma c minus x divided by c minus b. So this is nothing but 45 by 30. This is nothing but 15 by 30. So if you compare it, so this is nothing but 0.5. Okay. So if you compare these two, so here we have to take the minimum one. So the minimum is what? This one is the minimum one, which is 0.5. And if you compare 0.5 with 0, the maximum is what? 0.5. Similarly, there is an intersection with GE. So GE means what? 90, 120, 150. 90, 120 and 150. Okay. So we have to apply same formula. So this is nothing but our A, this is B and this is C. And this is nothing but our X. So X minus A, 105 minus 90 divided by B minus A, 120 minus 90, comma C minus X, 150 minus 105 by C minus B, 150 minus 120. So if you compare these two, so it is 15 by 30, it is 45 by 30. So the definitely minimum is what? This one is the minimum, which is nothing but 0.5. So it is 1 by 2, it is 0.5. And if you compare 0.5 with 0, the maximum is what? It is 0.5. Okay. So this 0.5 is a fuzzy value of this CRIPS 105 inside this fuzzy linguistic variable GE or fuzzy set GE. So if the fuzzy value of SD speed difference 80 and acceleration 105 is what? So you can see this is what our fuzzy partition. So if it is somewhere here, so it intersect with NM and NS. So it intersect with, it is NM is what? It is 0.33 and intersect with NS, which is nothing but what? It is 0.67. Are you getting? So if it is a speed difference is 80, then associated fuzzy value is 0.33 and 0.67 for NM and NS respectively. But remaining fuzzy value should be 0 because there is no intersection. Similarly, if A is 105, 105 is what? Somewhere here. It is 105. It is 80. 105 is what? This one. And associated intersect is what? It is 0.5. So if the acceleration is 105, then the fuzzy value is what? 0.5 and 0.5, but for both NS and GE respectively. Okay, so these are what fuzzy values for the speed difference. These are the what fuzzy values for the acceleration. Now we just see the rules. Now we see the rule strength calculations. So this is what our consequence antecedent part. This is what our consequent part. So 8 rules are there. Rule 1 to rule 8. Okay. Now rules are like this way. So if speed difference is NL and acceleration is GE, then throttle control is PL. Similarly, rule 2 is if speed difference is GE and acceleration is NL, then throttle control is what? It is PL. The fuzzy values are there. Here fuzzy values are there. If speed difference is 80, NM, fuzzy value of NM is what? 0.33 and fuzzy value of NS is what? 0.67. So how many NM are there? We can see only one NM is there. So the fuzzy value is what? 0.33. And how many NS are there? There is one single NS where associated fuzzy value is what? 0.67. Okay. Now we can see the acceleration part. In acceleration part, both for NS and GE, it is 0.5. So how many NS are there? You just see the how many NS are there. So here NS, NS. So only two NS are there where fuzzy value is what? 0.5, 0.5. And how many GE are there? So GE, GE. Okay. So only two GEs are there and GE are there. So three GEs are there. So associated fuzzy value is what? 0.5. Now here it is and is there. So they have definitely have to take the minimum in between that. So minimum in between is what? It is 0. The minimum 0, 0, 0. 0.33, 0.5. Minimum is what? 0.33. 0.67, 0. Minimum is what? 0. 0, 0.5. Minimum 0. 0, 0.5. Minimum 0. 0, 0.5. Minimum 0. 0, 0, 0. Okay. Now we can see here only positive medium fuzzy linguistic variable is active, it is 0.33. The remaining are 0. That means we have to consider only the positive medium for the throttle control. So we can see this is what our fuzzy linguistic fuzzy partition for the throttle control. Okay, so here only PM is 0.33. Now this is what our, this is the fuzzy value 0.33 for the fuzzy partition throttle control, and here it is only for PM only. The remaining values are 0. We can see, so the remaining values are zero. We can see 0, 0, 0, 0. Now it is what, 0.33, and it is 0. So definitely you have to consider this one only, and this is nothing but our fuzzy output. So definitely we have to convert this fuzzy output into CRISP output. So we have to consider the PM only. This is what our PM, where it is in between 150 to 210, 150 to 210, and 180 when it is maximum. So there is single is there. So we have to, first of all, you have to apply the identify the area and the center point. So center point is C1 is what? Center C is the center point, which is 180. So CRISP value, already you know how to calculate the CRISP value if you apply the center of sum method. So using center of sum method, we can apply this particular formula A1 C1, okay, A2 C2, like this way, AK CK divided by A1 plus A2 to AK. So K number of fuzzy partitions are there. Now here we can say here the only one is involved. So only one area is involved. So A1 into C, which is nothing but 180, divided by A1. So now the value will be what? C, which is nothing but 180. So in CRISP term, the throttle control is to be set 180. Okay, so this is what our CRISP output. Okay, this is okay. So two inputs are there, 80 and 105. These are what associated fuzzy values. Okay, now this is what rule strain calculation, and where we put all the values and we have to take the minimum one to see the output. Okay, so only PM is active. So when the is what 0.33, the value 0.33, that means we have to consider only this point, this particular area, which is nothing but our fuzzy output, and we have to convert this fuzzy output into CRISP output. To convert into CRISP output, we may apply center of sum method, but there is only single area is there, no more than one area is there. So definitely A1 into C by A1 is there, so no need to calculate the area. Direct that value C180 is the answer, will be the answer.
Now this is what Python implementation of speed control of a vehicle using fuzzy logic. So led to fuzzy inputs, speed difference and accelerations, and one fuzzy output total control TCB there. So inverse of discourse is what? It is 240. Now this is what our fuzzy partitions are there. So negative large, it is open left. Positive large, it is open right. And in between that, NM, NS, GE, PS, PM, all are the triangular fuzzy sets. So here associated parameters are given. Now these are what rules. Okay, 8 rules are there. And here we have to import the NumPy, and two inputs are there, speed difference, speed and the acceleration. Now here we display the inputs. Now function for open left right fuzzification. So this is a function to get the membership value of fuzzy set open left. This is the function through which we can get the membership value from the open right, and this is the function here we apply to get the fuzzy value of the, if it is a triangular. Now fuzzy partition, this is the fuzzy partition part. You can see these are fuzzy partition are there. So here in between x is in between 0 to 60 if it is open left. Okay, so if it is a negative large, in between 30 to 90 it is negative medium, in between 60 to 120 it is negative small, in between 90 to 150 it is 0, in between 120 to 180 it is positive small, in between 150 to 200 it is positive medium, and finally in between 180 to 240 it is positive large. And each and every time we have to call the function. So here we have to call the open left to get the associated fuzzy value of the input x. Okay, similarly we have to call the triangular triangular function to get the fuzzy value if the input is x. Similarly, here we have to write, you have to call the function OpenWrite to get the fuzzy value of the input x. Okay, so here getting fuzzy values of for all the inputs for all the fuzzy sets. So two inputs are there, speed and acceleration. So for both the inputs we call the same function partition. So we call the same function partition. So since both the fuzzy partitions are same, that's why we have called the same fuzzy partition function. If the fuzzy partitions are different for different inputs, so definitely for each and every partition we have to define separately. Okay, so here we display the fuzzy values for all the fuzzy sets. Now rules implementation. So to implement the rule, we call the function. We call this particular function. So we can see this one. So we call the function here in this particular rule. So see, you can here you can see this particular this tree. So if input if SD is NL and G is acceleration is G, then the consequent is what is positive large. Another rule is there when is speed difference is G and acceleration is NL, same the output positive large are there. So if both the positive large are satisfied, then we have to compare these two positive large to get the final positive large. Okay, so here also two positive mediums are there, that's why you have to compare these two positive medium, and two positive smalls are there, that's why you compare two positive small. But these two are the rules where single NS and NL are there, negative small and negative large are there, that's why we don't require any comparison for these two, because these two rules are the single NS and for NL. Now if it is PS and NS are there, is speed difference is PS and acceleration is NL, then you have to compare these two, because ANDing is there, that's why you have to take the minimum one and we can get the consequent throttle control part. Okay, now we can see the compare part. Here we compare if both the rules are non-zero, then we have to take the minimum one as a final throttle control. So if TC2 is small, then you have to take TC2 as a final. If otherwise, you have to take TC1 as a final. If any one is the if TC1 is zero, then the non-zero value you have to choose, you should choose for the output. And similarly, if TC2 is zero, then you have to non-zero, that is TC1, you have to choose for the throttle control. And here we use, and here we apply. In this way, we apply the compare function. Now we can see the this is what our defuzzification part. So here we calculate the area of a triangle, area of open left, area of open right. Okay, and here we apply the defuzzification technique. Okay, so defuzzification, here the function defuzzification, this is what our defuzzification function. Now starting from here, defuzzification functions are there. Okay, so till that defuzzification function is there. So here we can see if it is a positive large, if positive large is non-zero, that means what, we have to calculate the area for the positive large. If positive medium is non-zero, we have to calculate the area of that particular positive medium. Simultaneously, you have to calculate the central point also. So you have calculated the central point. So if it is a triangular, we no need to calculate separately, but if it is a open left and open right, then separately. So if it is open left and open right, so separately we have to calculate the center point of the area. So these are the, here we identify the fuzzy output. Okay, and we have to apply the defuzzification. So for each defuzzification we have to calculate the area, so area and the center point. Now sometimes it may be possible that no rule has satisfied, so in that case the denominator should be zero, that means no rules exist to give the result. So in that case we return the zero. Now if the denominator part is not zero, then definitely you have to calculate numerator by denominator to get the CRISP output, and we return that CRISP output. Now numerator is what? It is nothing but our implementation, like this one, a1 into x1 plus a2 into x2 plus a3 into x2 and so on. And denominator is what? Area1 plus area2 plus area3. Okay, so after that we can get the answer this one, and finally we can display the CRISP output. Now okay, so once again I just review the whole thing. So two inputs are there, Okay, so this is membership to calculate membership function for the open left, membership function for open right, membership function if it is a triangular. This is what our fuzzy partition part. Okay, display of the fuzzy values, display of the fuzzy values. Rule implementation, we use the implement the rules. So these are the stored rules. Okay, and here we display the fuzzy output. Now after the defuzzification is required, so we have to apply defuzzification technique to get the final crypts output. Okay, now we can execute it. So if the, we can see here, if the input is say, you can see here, if the input is 80 and the acceleration is 105, then you can see the output. So this is what our speed input is, what, 80, and acceleration input is what, 105, both are crypts. Now we have to apply the fuzzy values. So the speed, if speed is 80, so the fuzzy values are what, 0.33 and 0.67 for NM and NS respectively. And if the acceleration is 105, the fuzzy values are what, 0.5 and 0.5 respectively for NS and G respectively. Now this is what our fuzzy output. Now if it is a fuzzy output, it satisfied only the positive medium. So that's why it is 0.33. So the associated crisp value is what, it is 180. Okay, now we can see for the another input, say if it is a 40, then we can see the output. Now if it is a 40, input is 40 and acceleration, input and acceleration are 40 and 105 respectively. Now if it is input is 40, the associated crisp value, fuzzy values are what, 0.67 and 0.33 for NL and NM respectively. And definitely for acceleration, the fuzzy values are 0.5 and 0.5 for NS and G respectively. Fuzzy output, so we can say fuzzy output is satisfied both PL and PM, positive large and positive medium. So definitely the final crisp output is what, it is 198.35. Okay, now we can change to say if it is 100. Now you can see the, if any, can get any output or not. Now here also we can get the output, it is 150. Okay, so we have changed that. These are the fuzzy values, these are the fuzzy output and final crisp output. Now if it is 120, now you can see. So also the same thing. Now what about if both are 125 and 120? Now you can see here, speed input is 120 and 125 respectively. These are the fuzzy values, but here no rule is satisfied. So no rule exists to give the result. Okay, so this is what our implementation of the speed control of a vehicle using Python. Okay, now if it is open left, how to calculate the area for defuzzification? So this is what our 0, alpha and beta. So in alpha it is 1 and when it is beta it is 0. So suppose it is our fuzzy value, so this is the area, we have to calculate the area. So this is what our trapezoid. So first of all we have to calculate the x value to know the this distance. Okay, so to know this particular distance, we have to calculate the x. So to get the x, we can calculate beta minus mu x into beta minus alpha. Now from this we can get the x value. Okay, now area will be 1 by 2 into the height. Height is what, the membership value mu x plus the this distance, this length. So this is what, beta minus 0, beta plus this distance, this is what our x. So if we apply this particular formula, we can calculate the area of this particular shaded part. And after that we can get the center point. So to get the center point, we may just use the middle point of the trapezoid. So beta minus 0, so that means beta by 2, that particular value is nothing but the center point. Okay. Now if it is an open right, we can calculate the area. So this is what our fuzzy value, mu x is the fuzzy value. So this is the part this is the area we have to calculate. So this is also a trapezoid. Now to get this particular trapezoid, we need the half into mu x, half into the height. Height is what, it is mu x, and into length of this. So how to calculate this particular length? It should be nothing but 240 minus alpha, get it. And to get this particular length, we should know 240 minus this x value. Now to get x value, we can use this particular formula, beta minus alpha into mu x plus alpha. So if you know, if you calculate, if you put these values, you can get this particular x value. And all, if you know this particular x value, you can calculate that this distance, that is 240 minus x. So 240 minus x. And similarly, if you can Now to calculate C1, we can use this particular formula 1 by 2 240 minus alpha by 2 plus alpha. We can get the center point of this particular trapezoid.
Now we can see this is what our triangular and mu x is the output. Now this is what mu is, this is what trapezoid is there. It's the mu x, it is given. So first of all, already you know the area of a trapezoid. Suppose area we want to calculate of a trapezoid 1 by 2 into the height. So this is nothing but our height. So this is nothing but mu x. And we have to calculate this length, that is what? C minus A. That means this length plus this length plus D. Okay. So the D is what? D means D is it D. We have to calculate the D. D means what? We can say x2 minus x1. So d is equal to what? X2 minus x1. So we have to identify this x1 as well as x2. So x1 is what? To get the x1, you can apply this particular formula mu x into b minus a plus a. So here a, b, c are the parameter. So when this particular fuzzy set is maximum, b, when at b the value is what? Maximum. Similarly, how to get the x2? To get x2, it is c minus mu x into c minus b. So through this particular form, we can get the x2. Then we can apply x2 minus x1 to get the d value. So area is what? 1 by 2 into mu x into x2 minus x1, that is d, plus c minus a, that means this length. So this length plus this length. So this is nothing but our this particular length. This one is what? This particular length. So if you solve it, you can get this. And c1 is what? The middle point is what? It is b. So we can see one simple example. So here, you can say it is 60, 90 and 120. Okay. Now here, x1 is what? X1, for x1 you have to apply mu x 0.33 into b minus a, 90 minus 60 plus e 60. So x1 is what? 69.9. So this will be what? 69.9. Similarly, to get x2, we can apply this particular formula. X2 is what? C minus mu x. You can see here. Okay, are you getting this one? C minus mu x. So 120 minus 0.33, C minus mu x 0.33 into 120 C minus b, 120 minus 90. So if you solve it, answer is what? 110.1. So this will be what? This will be 110.1. So what is the d value? The d1 value is what? Or the d value is what? X2 minus x1. So 110.1 minus 16.9, that is 40.2. So the length is 14.2. So d2 is what? It is the 120 minus 60. So area will be what? 1 by 2 into height into addition of these two length. So 60 plus 40.2. So if you solve it, you can say answer 16.533. And the center point is what? It is 90. Because, are you getting? Now, here we have for each and every triangular fuzzy sets, we may apply this particular formula to calculate area as well as the center of the area. And then we have to apply this particular formula. So the center of some method is what? A1 into C1 plus A2 into C2 to An into Cn divided by A1 plus A2 plus An. So n number of fuzzy sets are there. Okay. Now, if two fuzzy triangular are satisfied, so this is what our fuzzy output. Say this is our fuzzy output. So we have to calculate the area of this particular fuzzy set as well as area of this particular. So A1, this is A1, this is A2, and this is C1, center point, this is C2. So area will be what? A1 into C1 plus A2 into C2 by A1 plus A2. Similarly, if it is the case, say the, in that case, you have to apply area of this particular fuzzy part. Now it satisfied mu1 only. So this is the area, it is satisfied, and for mu2 it is this one. So we have to calculate area of this plus this one. So A1 into C1 plus A2 into C2 by A1 plus A2. Similarly, if it is the case, and this is for say mu1 and this is for mu2. So we have to calculate area 2 and area 1. So then we have to apply same formula. In this case, three fuzzy sets are satisfied. So we can say this is what our mu1 output, this is what our mu2, and this is what mu2. So this is fuzzy sets, fuzzy output. So to get crisp output, we have to calculate area for these three trapezoid and centers of these three trapezoid, and we can apply this particular formula to get the answer. Okay, so that is the end of this particular video. Thank you very much.